Call this meeting to order. Please rise for flag salute. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. All right. Roll call, please.
Mic's working?
Lights, are they working?
Oh, I thought you were saying mic is working.
Testing, testing.
Oh, okay. Mayor Kapas.
Here.
Mrs. Pasio.
Here.
Mr. Venieri.
Here. Brian.
Mr. Farrell.
Here.
Mrs. Kelly.
Here.
Good timing.
Mr. Root is out this evening.
You're supposed to have Danny Law.
He's not here yet.
Not yet. Mr. Bayshore.
Absolutely. I'm not enough.
Mr. Bob.
Here too.
Mr. Wright is out. Okay, public notice of this meeting pursuant to the Open Public Meetings Act has been given by the clerk in the following manner. One, posted on the bulletin board in the Borough Clerk's office on January 4th, 2017. And two, emailed to the retrospect and covered vote on January 4th, 2017. We're going to skip the agenda just a little bit because our engineer has another engagement. One of our engineers is going to leave, so I'm going to turn this over to Mr. Bob to explain an issue we have with our building that we have to resolve.
So we have the ongoing municipal building interior renovations, our clerk's office renovations. This is for the exterior vestibule plus the changes in wall configurations and everything. We have worked through the process from the time we went out to bid and received contracts. There was additional considerations brought to our attention by Carlos staff. And also there was one provision where we had the angle wall out front where we really wanted to straighten that out. So we have worked through probably a list of 30 some odd items, which when we requested for pricing from the contractor added up to over 30 something thousand dollars, which was not reasonable. We have been successful on bringing them down, where we can have all the interior work with the exception of the mailbox system done by the contractor during the contractor's time period. So it's his dust control, his cleanup, his finish painting, his floor replacement. And that way they're in and out and not bring additional subcontractors. We looked at the cost of, and so this 30 is now down to 16. We looked at the cost of bringing in subcontractors to do some of the electrical changes, data changes, and straightening out that wall. You're not saving any additional monies by subbing out the additional vendors. All you're going to do is extend the amount of time that you're going to be disrupted from the working staff. So with that, we're recommending that we proceed with that change order. Included in this change order also, that's why you see the total amount of change order, $20,000, is the roof leader system, which was not known, which was under the original brick wall up front that had to be reworked when the contractor was putting in.
You know about the drainage?
The drain.
All the drains, until we dug it up, you couldn't see the pipes.
And there was additional rework, and we had to actually reverse grade and take one.
And that was already done.
It's done.
That was already approved.
Done, negotiated, already approved. And then also we had the changing from the generic lights to the matching lights on the exterior.
They matched the lights on the block.
This was a very long process. It always is when you're cutting into existing buildings. But this will get us where they come in 2 weeks. They tarp everything off of plastic. They do their work. They clean up everything else, untarp, and they're gone. And we have a
clean product. We're done inside.
Correct.
And that's going to be in what? In the space of how long?
2 weeks, and then I believe another 30 days, I believe, is what their time period was.
So 6 weeks.
When do they plan on starting?
In 2 weeks.
In 2 weeks.
They want everything in place, and that's why.
2 weeks and 4 weeks ago.
Yes. And that's why we wanted everything resolved and make sure we had an understanding, not only with the governing body, but also their CFO and everything else. That's why.
But they've already ordered the doors, right?
I released the doors myself in anticipation that.
Did you pick them up too?
But that was a while ago.
Did you deliver them?
Exactly.
Okay.
No, I didn't.
Do you need a resolution to approve this change order?
I mean, this could be caught this discussion and just put on the change.
What is the change? You said 30, you got 16 left, or 30?
Yeah, so. Originally, the change order items were totaling $30,000.
Right.
We got it down to 16.
Oh, great.
Because we just got Yeah.
We start on time.
So the total change order is just site work for the roof leaders plus the decorative lights and match the building. And everything is $20,503.39. Again.
I think that's very reasonable.
It is for the work they're doing with everything. Now, also, this includes, because of a certain door change that was requested by the CFO, it actually allows for an additional workstation. So we're having the, instead of all the power being mounted to the columns as currently exist,
we're spreading
that on the walls on both sides, because the most flexibility that you ever would need in that space for moving people around.
All the electricity was in the two columns. Now this splits along the whole wall, so you could be on either, well, you know what, desk, when you try to move the desk around.
And plus, right now, I think on the columns, everything's off extension cords. It's going to eliminate that, because now you have desks.
Extension cords are banned.
Now you have desks, you'd be able to plug your stuff and bring behind the desk in all the four quadrants. So that is our recommendation.
Okay. You do need a resolution.
It doesn't have to be this evening, as long as I have an understanding.
I will put it on for the March meeting, and we'll just do a resolution.
The details of whatever that has to be.
So you don't, do these need to be signed? Are you okay with this?
I already.
You guys brought the contract. If we want to do a resolution, we could do it tonight. It's a public meeting.
Why don't you give a little?
Okay, that's fine.
Let's get it over.
Yeah.
That's fine.
100% do it.
All right.
Okay, so resolution 17-42 is a resolution to approve the change order.
Right, change order number one.
Change order number one.
For the Runnymede Municipal Building interior renovation and site improvements project. In the amount of?
$20,000.
$20,503.39.
Did you get all that, Joyce?
$20,503.39.
Can I make a motion?
Yes.
I'll make a motion.
Any further discussion? Bob, is there any?
Anybody second it?
I'll second that motion.
Okay, motion by Mr. Ranieri, second by Ms. Passio. Roll call, please.
Mrs. Passio.
Yes.
Mr. Ranieri.
Yes.
Mr. Brower.
Yes.
Mrs. Kelly.
Yes.
I think that's all that's here, is that correct? Can I miss anybody?
Yeah, that's it. Four ayes, and the resolution is.
I mean, thank you for your patience on all these moving parts on this project, but we believe that it's a good solution for all the public staff, CFO in this part. And the straightened out wall, which is by the front door right now, where it's on the angle, that's going to be straightened out. It will be framed for a future through wall mailbox system. So we're going to have that framed out, we're going to have that picked out before they frame it, so we'll be coordinating that shortly.
That's great.
Mark will be able to.
Sounds wonderful.
Mark will be able to go through everything else, and then we will have an upcoming engineering meeting very shortly. Wrapping this up and talking with the CFO earlier today, we are working towards having our capital program projected book, our projected capital program book, which is all the costs projected for construction, nothing else for all the items that were listed. That'll be prepared, circulated to the engineering committee first, and then it'll be out to everyone. Again, just because items are not, or in our book, it's just for consideration by government body.
I want to give an idea on what we're looking at, roads we've been talking about for years.
The ideas that everybody has been talking about.
Improvements to the buildings that we've been talking about for years.
We've done this, we haven't done one in about 3 years, because we're sort of just wrapping up everything that was in your prior program. So this kind of gives you an idea of, if you were to proceed with these items, this is what the cost would be, so you make.
Estimated cost. Intelligent.
For budget cover purposes, these would be informed decisions, so you really can analyze your budget needs.
And when will that be ready?
We're hoping by the end of next week, which was acceptable to the CFO. It may drift a little bit into the following week, but our target is trying to get it all out to you next week, so I need your word.
And it's called what, capital?
Your capital improvement program.
And one last thing, since you're here, and the public works superintendent's here, is there anything that you need from Mr. Bach? How are we doing with items that were asked for by the public works department?
They should be all included.
Okay, this will be part of this idea, some of the mapping stuff we wanted to do.
The asphalt for the storm and sanitary.
Storm and sanitary, so if we can fund it.
Yes.
Some of the things that Harry had asked for.
So we're just trying to find, and it's a nice resource, instead of having multiple memos and documents, have it all in a booklet, and we're going to consistently, along with the engineering committee, if things change, we'll update them. And also, what we try to do is, the best ability that the engineer can is note as we make revisions to the booklet where funding sources are coming from. So, for the DOT, the fire funded project will know that it's DOT grant such and such. So it's almost a nice tracking device that we can kind of put back in place.
That's great.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, Steve.
Thank you, Steve. Have a good day. What's on the agenda? What's your question?
Sell it, no.
The market will take it easy to them.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
I'll sign it before we leave. All right, we'll continue with our meeting then. On the agenda, we have five raffle licenses. These don't need to be done tonight, right? Next week? And just to make it clear to everyone here, not to make the meeting go too long, but it's important that we communicate to our organizations throughout our town that this licensing process is imposed upon us by the state. And it's been a hurdle for some of our nonprofits doing it, but once they get it done, it's easy. Well, relatively easy, right, Joyce? It's relatively easy.
You just follow the form in 2 years.
Do the paperwork.
Correct. They have to do the initial application. That seems to be the problem.
Yeah.
They don't want to put the effort into that.
Okay. Second item on the list is discussion of street opening ordinance. We have a current one that we mimicked from Deptford MUA, I believe, Deptford Township. And one of the things we're looking to do is make a few changes. Not that the engineer isn't very helpful to this, but one of the things we're going to do is look at our public works department to be more involved with the process. So this is more of a legal thing. The discussion part of it is, so what we have, and you can have this, is an ordinance, but it has to blend with what the, so we have the one that our engineer proposed for us and we have adopted. We have some ideas and some changes from our public works department.
What are you red?
I think the red light, is that what you want, the red items, is that what you did? Did you redline things?
No, I can't recall one. I know Joyce Glenn has it already.
Well,
I said it's
Leonard, Tiffany might have been working on it. Maybe she started redlining it, and maybe I printed it out.
That might be where it's already.
So some of the changes might be, you know,
verbiage.
Yeah, between the engineering department and the public works department to evaluate these road openings, and get the applications in, do inspections, make sure the work gets done, go back and re-inspect, do the work ourselves.
Yeah.
If the work isn't done properly or have it work done, and then use these fees to cover our costs. Is that pretty much the long and short of it?
I've always been in the fees to cover the cost.
Fees to cover the cost to fix anything.
That's what it is.
Yes.
Exactly.
And that was the intent. What was happening was people were tearing up our roads, and they weren't fixing the roads properly, or, you know, we've done a better job this past year. We were really, because the engineer was much more involved, but I think on that we're sort of slowed down a little bit, but now we have a little bit of jumping around.
Who's inspecting the final patch show?
Right now, the engineer does a preliminary assessment, determines the fees and the impact. That's been working out very well. The inspections after the work is done, I think, has been working out pretty good too. I think where we have our little bit of a lag is probably the follow-up of the final once the ground settles. There's been some pushback. How do we get the people back to come do it?
Spot doing the inspection?
That's what I'm pointing to Mark and his department. You want to elaborate just a little?
If there was a large program that came through where South Jersey Gas was going through an entire neighborhood, and you were here daily to inspect those.
Yeah. It was a lot of work.
But if they have an individual one, we have not been going out for those. We've been helping get up
the larger. And so this is, we want to capture not only the big project where South Jersey Gas literally did, what, 85 houses and did every single one, it might have been more than that, and as opposed to a dig up or a sewer line or something else. So somehow we got to get this a little bit better. And the reason, this is all complaint driven. Our residents are complaining because something's not being repaired properly. And that's been a lot.
Are there engineering fees for the inspection?
Yeah, we've been reimbursed. I mean, there's a fee from them, but we get reimbursed.
Gotcha.
From the applicant.
If you're probably worse than handling just the small individual ones.
Yeah.
You make out that because
that's what I mean.
Small opening.
That's where I'm at.
Small opening up to 20 square feet is only $100.
Right.
And by the time we start reviewing the application, that $100 gets chewed up.
Right. So we can
and
do
then
small.
It's going to start crossing the first. So it's something to
probably double the count.
And just give us another tool. Either public works engineer, somebody gets it done.
Exactly.
So that's our big thing is tweaking.
Yeah, I'll turn it around.
Yeah, and I don't know what our existing.
Coordinating of how.
Well, I think everything gets originated through Joyce.
Joy.
Joy in our office. Anytime a street opening application comes, it comes to Joy. At that point, there's a mechanism to go through public works and engineering to get it done. But then we need another mechanism to follow.
So she would know whether to call Harry or whether...
Well, I think really, maybe the first step would be Joy would give it to Harry. Harry then gives it to either.
Okay.
If it's what he wants to do, he does it. He wants Buck to do it, it's what Buck wants.
That's a good order.
I'm okay like that.
I think Joy can make that determination of which one.
You also have a moratorium.
On certain streets.
So Joy may come to me first, finding out that the street has a moratorium. And I just advise what the fee is. And at that point, we can figure out how to do it.
We only have a couple of streets that have moratoriums.
I do moratorium, we've done a lot of streets within the past 5 years.
Those are the streets we have now. Okay, so you understand we're doing that?
Yeah.
Okay, resolution to extend the copy paper contract with the county co-op?
Well, that's...
That's very simple. Discussion of the Verizon agreement. This was sent over to your office.
It was, oh yeah, we did it manually as well, so...
No big deal?
No, it's no big deal. What they do is there's nodes, what they're called, is they're little antennas that I think are like 20 inches that go on top of the existing utility pole. They need our consent in order to do that. We cannot deny them.
What is nodes for?
This wireless service kind of thing. It's just like the newest, latest and greatest technology to improve, you know, the way they...
Coverage
and everything like that, so...
So we can't deny it, we have to...
But we have to approve.
We have to approve it, but we can require reasonable restrictions. The example of they are responsible for the damage, and that's in there, and that they need to keep their own insurance. So that's in there, those are the reasonable restrictions, everything else looks in good order. Nothing that's gonna notice, it's not an eyesore, it's just literally a 20 inch, what's called a node, a little antenna that are on top of the existing utility lines located in our right of way, and because it's located in our right of way, that's why we need our permission.
Okay, so Joyce will put that on.
Dan sent me a sample resolution.
Yeah, we'll put it on.
Harry, this question.
Following this on the shore communities, they've been arguing this back and forth because Verizon is technically not a utility. That's what they, the decision came down, that this township is really going after them about this. Because it's still PSE&G poles, they have to get permission from them still to put the nodes on there. And with the shore communities are doing, they're actually charging the fee for each one put up.
Well, I thought in the application, I thought in that agreement it said we could charge a reasonable construction application.
So I just wanted to bring that up, just follow up on that.
I'm surprised they got them on the poles. Why couldn't they just put them on a building here and there?
They've gotten smaller already. We had an application in a planning board to go on a building. But there was, if you saw that, is that what you're talking about? Dennis was able to at least impose a minimal fee?
I don't know if it was finalized after they came out.
But there was a line in there.
You can do it as long as it's reasonable, nothing absorbed in it, but it's only a little something.
Because Dennis had to, once they do it, you're gonna have the other cell companies come in and do it. And that's why they...
Well, don't charge them a door once.
But would they be putting an application into our construction department to put these up?
They don't have to.
So there's no inspections, there's no...
There's no inspection or anything like that. I mean, I don't know if I go that far to kind of pick a fight with that, especially when it's just, it's literally attaching a little thing on top of an already existing pole. When it's...
So...
$25 a pole.
So what would be a reasonable fee?
But we're not doing anything.
Oh, yeah.
The agreement says that if for some reason we had to do anything.
Correct.
We can charge a reasonable...
$25 a month for a pole.
If it's in our way or anything like that, it's literally like, yay big, it's as big as this pad.
So if there was an inspection, we could charge...
We pay for all the street lighting, it's a fortune, you know, on those poles. So they're probably, I'm not against the fee.
But we also collect a tax, if you look at your phone bill, if you look at all your electric bill, there's a tax that's collected that's given back to the, well, it's given to the state, and the state gives it to us.
Is that something where...
They're still under negotiation because they do not report to the Board of Public Utilities.
Yeah, I'm not, is that a battle worth getting?
Well, I'm just saying all the towns are jumping in on it, follow that.
Because your point is that it's Verizon.
The ones around here are pretty much falling in line with that. Wasn't a fee, you can do it. It'd be a little unique, I guess, to this area.
It's going with every pole, or how?
Just the ones in the right of way.
Are they up yet? Are they up yet?
No,
they can't get away from
it. They have to wait for our permission, they can't do that. How many are we talking about?
It doesn't say.
I would guess more than a handful.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Yeah, it's not that long of a stretch.
Bikers, Pike, Country Road.
Two two square miles.
I don't think we do. They're not doing it in the neighborhood.
You can't imagine there's more than 10.
I think it's pretty long. Did Magnolia already pass it?
Yeah. We passed it last month, and Stratford did it as well, yes. I hear, you can, I'm just not sure.
It's what, if you don't allow it?
When we're on an island, are you example of Magnolia, Stratford, all the other towns that have done it? Yeah, we can't not allow it.
Can't not.
Well, no, Harry's point is they're not considered a public.
And we were, that's one of the things that I don't want to take the lead on. If other towns were doing it, I would be fine jumping on board.
Like Dennis Township, or that one. Well, it does say we can close the fee.
The bear.
I think there's a watch it, just to say it.
Yeah.
Because then the other goes up to the other cell providers. You have Verizon, like, have one on every 25 poles, and then the other ones come in between them and stuff.
Metro, and all those.
Well, then we'll charge.
I'll say that to you guys.
Okay.
I'll put it this way, you're not getting a lot.
No.
Okay, that's fine. So this resolution to rescind the liquor license from.
What's that about?
State of New Jersey called us up, and if you remember, our chief of police went and took it down because they didn't pay their $1,375.
Last year, they met the requirements as far as we were concerned. They renewed your license. But what I did know was their license remained inactive. They never opened the bar.
Oh, they never opened?
They never opened.
So they paid us.
So they paid us, but they are not permitted to.
Have a license and not.
And not use it. So I had to send Paul over last, a few months after we gave them to pick up the license.
Is there any discussion of selling to somebody else?
No.
They're just not opening the bar?
At this point, but, you know, they weren't. So I received a call from the state liquor board saying, did you do action to a resolution to rescind it when you took, and we did.
Oh.
So Paul moved it.
So essentially it's memorializing something that's already a fact.
Correct. And they have to go, they have to get a 1239 ruling before they can activate the license again, which is not a problem. Other licenses and establishments have done that before.
I'd say ABC is cracking down on people. I mean, and my role as Boston County Prosecutor, there are two different establishments where they are going after liquor licenses for serving underage patrons. Mm-hmm. And it's Tilt to Kill was one of them, and I can't go with that.
That quick, huh?
That quick.
So that'll be a resolution then. We'll put that on for next week. So it's a resolution just rescinding the liquor license. Discussion of the MOU with the county for the POD site at Harry Williams Building. A member of understanding was POD.
It's a point of distribution.
Of what?
So I guess we signed up years ago to be a point of
distribution. Oh, you're talking about the health department?
Yes.
Oh.
Well, they set a renewal.
In case of a disaster?
Yes.
Asking us to.
I think still one of the big one.
Harry Williams Community.
Memorandum of understanding. But so all this is. You know.
If not Charlie does.
This is some Office of Emergency Management and the health department. So the idea is if there was something that happened in our town.
Well, don't you think Harry should know about it?
He should know. He was asked that he did know. I don't believe he was not.
I don't know about running, but I know about the practice of it, what they did from my previous appointment. But yes, it's a.
We must have had a agreement before.
Yeah, we did.
They would post it, they have had the resolutions authorizing it for their insurance and so forth. But if there's ever any situation, the residents of Running can go to this spot.
But even the county, they can use it.
Yes, they can use it. That's what it is. It's county comes in and they disperse the medications and so forth.
Okay.
So we'll do that.
We did this under Jimmy's administration.
We did it, okay, so we'll put that on also. So we'll just approve that MOU. Is that all we're doing is?
Yeah, we're just authorized that the Harry Williams Building is a point of distribution.
All right, 1701 public hearing ordinance. Which one was that? Is that our?
That is the property, abandoned property.
Yeah, so you guys did that too, right?
Yeah.
So we're gonna do it, and I think we did first reading, and it'll be second reading, right?
Everybody here knows how I feel about it.
How do you feel?
Unbelievable.
Think it's good?
Great.
It's good to know.
I think the biggest problem that municipalities are facing, I think it's the one constant, there, every time we do, has like just separate community problems, that is one where it is everywhere.
Yeah, and houses not here.
Oh my God, yeah.
No, it's.
It is great. Love it.
We should have done a shared service agreement with county for abandoned, that's it, right?
I would have the second part.
There's two parts.
So we have to adopt the ordinance.
Adopt the ordinance and then enter into the shared service.
And then enter into the agreement. So we'll do that next meeting. Discussion of appointment of additional housing inspector.
Yeah,
All right, I received a letter from Mr. Mecca. Basically, because of these abandoned homes going through a lot of rehab, that there is a need for additional home inspections. So I'll just read it to you very quickly. Mayor and Council, I'm requesting that you appoint Buck Tuthill to the position of housing inspector. He's already our part-time inspector, but he does code enforcement. He will be needed for 2 hours on Tuesdays and Thursdays to help with the housing inspections. He is prepared and ready to exist. During this, he will help us with the as a qualified inspector in the absence of Mr. Reed or Mr. Knight, if they're not available to do it. Buck has shown he is capable of requesting. Thank you for consideration. So at this point, we get $100 every time you do a CO inspection. So if he comes in for 2 hours, we're going to be fine. If he does at least one, if he does two, we're doing very well. I think one of the issues that that department's running into is they're getting phone calls. People want to get their houses sold, and they're saying,
they want those COs right away.
We can't wait 2 weeks for inspectors. So
that's right.
Right now, Keith and Ed are able to do it, but I only do it on certain days, and this would now, I think, fill in a couple of those other days. So if someone calls in.
Hey, as long as these houses go on the market and we can sell them, the faster we can move this along, the better I like it.
Yeah, I think it's just a resolution. I think we can.
Is there a monetary amount?
There is a monetary, but it's his current hourly. We're not changing the gentleman's hourly rate.
Just giving him more hours.
I don't think that's never said on this.
I would just do it as a resolution.
Resolution.
Just to memorialize anything.
Yeah, there's no change in his salary. He's already an employee. Can I make it part of the appointment resolution saying
that he's now the housing inspector?
I would just do it to say you did it in the event that it comes up later on.
Okay, let's do it for next month, and we'll just put it on. Well, first of all, I'll let him know because I think he has to go take a class. So we'll let him know that we'll plan.
What's his title? Additional housing inspector.
But he has to go take a class, I think, and then he'll be able to go. Okay. And once again, that is a direct result of homes that are going through this process.
Semi-annual fee that we're going to collect as part of this ordinance.
So it'll cover these costs. Amendment to salary ordinance together with resolution authorizing salary. Is that part of the same thing?
That's done. That's me.
When we did our salary ordinance, we didn't put a range.
The range isn't high enough.
Yeah, so we're going to just do a wider range to cover. Right now, Ms. Pinto is covering as our planning board secretary. So we need to amend our salary ordinance to just say from 0 to 5,000 or 10,000. Right now, we don't have anybody. What was that? Do you even have the old ordinance, or do we know what it was?
Yeah, actually, it's 1,000 to 3,500.
So we'll do 1 to 6?
1 to 6 is what Rich suggested.
Okay, so we're just going to amend it to 1 to 6.
And then you need to appoint.
Okay, the planning board appointed Ms. Pinto to be the planning board secretary, but we now have to authorize it. So we have to do a resolution authorizing her to. So we'll put that on for next.
Boy, I'll tell you, next one's going to be busy.
Yeah.
We've got some things. Okay, so we might as well get to the business, then we'll go around the table. Resolution 17-40 is a resolution supporting Sustainable Jersey Grant application. This was given to us by Ms. Adair.
Yes.
Is there a motion to approve this?
I make a motion to approve the resolution supporting Sustainable Jersey Grant application. I'll second that motion.
Motion by Ms. Passio, second by Ms. Kelly. Any discussion? What was this one? The application for which thing?
The application is for Butterfly Gardens around our town, and I believe she's applying for the $2,000 grant, which is probably easier to get than the $20,000 and the $10,000.
All right. We got a motion, a second. Any other discussion? It's not a roll call.
Correct me?
Yeah, exactly.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? All right, the resolution is adopted. Resolution 17-41 is a resolution authorizing purchase of a trash truck from Stone Harbor. We'll let Mr. Wasson just update us quickly on this.
What's going on there? this is the first I'm hearing.
We have, through my connections
Well, this was discussed last month.
Yeah, for my past employer, that they rotate their vehicles out quite often, and they take superb care of their vehicles. So we had a 1988 20-yard Peterbilt Packer, and Stone Harbor has a 2005 20-yard automatic with a snowplow truck that they offered for $20,000. So with that, we had first bids on it. They passed the resolution 3 weeks ago authorizing for us to purchase it, and this is authorizing us to purchase it. And the funds will come out of 2016 capital that we did have money left over from the previous truck purchase we saved money on. So we're taking it from there. So it is.
So we're replacing that vehicle. That old vehicle goes away.
Yeah, so what are you going to do with the old?
No, the 88 goes away.
So what are you going to do with it? Auction, or just go?
We're going to try for auction, but the last trash truck we wound up scrapping because it went to auction 3 times, nothing happened out of it, so we got to scrap it for it.
I know.
It still drives.
Yes.
So you at least drive it to the.
Yeah, but it's starting to come. It's starting to come where we have to put a lot of money into it for maintenance and safety and so forth.
Really,
so this one here is considered a very great upgrade for being used.
What year is it?
2005, I do believe.
Sorry, does cold weather cause
17 years younger
vehicles as it does on like the HVAC equipment?
Yes, it does. But Stump Harbor parks their trucks in garages every night, and they get power washed once a week.
Love to hear that. That's wonderful.
Well, Stump, they have a tremendous amount of trash pickup in the summertime. Yes. I mean, the amount of trash recycling.
They're equal to this town. They run 6 trucks. They do trash pickup twice a week and recycle twice a week, 6 days a week, or summertime, commercial 7 days a week. So they double their staff in summertime, and they to meet the criteria. So with that, so like I said, they have a maintenance program. Their tax base is
very. What's the value on that truck?
I do believe it's approximately 30 some thousand.
Goodbye.
So with that,
you made money.
We had the information taken to the engineers.
The engineer did Mr. Bach a documentation.
So he reviewed all the paperwork, pictures of it, and so forth, and the value, you know, looking at the research value, and all the price.
Great.
Okay.
Goodbye.
So we can do this evening. So resolution 1741, is there a motion to approve?
I'll make a motion to approve.
I'll second that motion.
All right, motion by Mr. Maneri, second by Ms. Kelly. Any other discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Farrell?
Yes.
Mrs. Kelly?
Yes.
Mrs. Passio?
Yes.
Mr. Ruger?
Yes.
For us.
All right, the resolution is adopted. We're going to let Ms. Passio and Ms. Kelly go because I know they have.
Wanted to touch base about the tolling agreements. What are we doing with that?
I was under the impression that both towing, there were 2 applicants. Both have been evaluated, and an email was sent to us. Your committee is going to have to do its review and make a recommendation to all of us, and then we can award.
Who's the two?
The 2 were Bernie Stowing, who did it last year, and Real Stowing, and they're out of Deptford. And I believe that both were qualified to do it. It's just a matter of what we want to do. The committee should review it, okay? Now, if you want to get it done before the caucus meeting, or excuse me, the council meeting, we have a short week, but it is possible. But if you guys, if you have time to get together, we'll get together.
We're meeting on the 2nd.
I've heard our contractor has been fine from what I've heard.
Are we satisfied with Bernie?
Oh, he's doing a great job.
Yeah, I don't know.
Everybody is happy that he's there, been by, gets the job done, cleans up beautiful.
And his office, I mean, he's got an office in town, and he's got, I think, 2 of his employees live in town, and I think that's made it very quick. Sometimes they show up before the police.
Well, the real guy, that drives the real truck, he lives in town too. He lives across the way from where he's.
Oh, does he live in town?
Sicilian Tesla's
group. Oh, so that makes sense. Yeah. That makes sense why they apply. Oh, I wasn't sure. I thought they were located in Deptford.
Well, he drives the truck and he parks it right across the way from my son's. That's how I know.
Okay. All right, so if you guys want to do that, we can kind of walk that on next week. Joyce is hearing it at least.
We'll be meeting March 2nd at 4:30, and we'll handle it then.
Okay, anything else?
I think that's it for me.
Okay.
Okay, for me, I'm going to do my report next week.
At the meeting, Rob?
I'll give my report, yes, I don't think I have anything.
Okay, they have a dinner to go to.
That's okay.
You're all invited.
Yes, you are.
I smelled it, I felt it.
Oh, you were over there?
I was over there.
Well, this is an extended, after you guys leave, we do an extended meeting, we're gonna really dive into it. We're going to 11 o'clock, we're gonna go detail line by line.
But you're not gonna have any resolutions or anything, that's what you're gonna lose your form.
No, I'll hang around, I don't care.
We have no more resolutions, we're just gonna do reports.
As long as there's no resolutions.
Good luck, good luck.
Not making fun.
I have to.
Well, you're sitting with a big chair.
Harry, I gave you that because I think I sent you an email with the flyer, but you'll see what's going on with that.
How's she doing?
Got a good name?
How old is she?
There's everything, he's done it for 8 years now, so.
Up, moving around. Take her out the sun?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's all I got, that's all I have, so you're good? If you wanna stay, you can.
I'll hang around a little bit longer.
Okay, sure, okay, although we'll see you over there.
I brought my food already, it's there.
Oh, I brought my food, but if she starts anything, I have to put it on the record.
It's half blue.
Half blue.
Okay, I do it.
Mr. Harry, do you have anything?
I'm gonna leave in five minutes. I'm gonna leave in 5 minutes.
Yeah, just.
And come over, the food is fabulous.
Finance, we're still living steady.
You know.
Couple awkward with our temporary budget, our goal is to have everything wrapped up and introduce our 2017 budget beginning in April, possibly the general meeting. On a different note, I was at Green Acres today, thanks Harry for putting that trash receptacle. He put a nice recycled trash receptacle on the far side of the track where everybody's just throwing litter in the woods, looks great. Other than that, progress.
Can I just ask you one question since you were down there? Have they put those chimes down there in the playground?
Well, that's what I wanted to discuss. Yeah, the Rotary Club is donating two more pieces of equipment to the town. And we've now, well, we were a little bit involved because we had the pavilion built and the engineer, I think, you guys at least, somebody made sure that, or maybe we hired an engineer, the Rotary hired an engineer. They did, if you can believe it. But my point though, what I'm trying to say is, Rotary Club and other organizations want to donate to town. Should we have a more formal process to accept it or review it, accept it? And, you know, like for example, these two pieces of equipment that Ms. Passy was talking about are two musical instruments that are being donated in the names of two past Rotarians that passed. So the money was donated, and did you know what they are? They're chimes. So I'm glad I don't put it down there. But my point though is that obviously there should be some input of where they're being located for safety reasons, and we're going to be maintaining it. But should there be a formal resolution that's accepting it?
You know what I mean?
I know you're going to say yes, right?
Is that in case something gets hurt on a piece of equipment?
Well, the GIF should be notified.
Well, it's just to cover ourselves.
Yeah.
Especially on the back end.
I think we did it with the pavilion.
What the intended use is.
Okay.
What the purpose of it for. What they want. Is there any terms and conditions? Because some people will donate something to you saying, we'll give you this, but you can only use it for X amount of years for this sole purpose. And that kind of thing. So rather than, yeah, we'll take anything from anybody, just, you know, a more delineated process kind of thing, I would care for that.
So the only thing I would ask is you guys, Mr. Ruth, his wife is the vice president of the Rotary Club.
President?
Vice president.
Didn't you tell me she was president?
Mike Balbatten was the president.
Yeah, not yet.
And if we had drawings, what they look like, how they get installed, where they go, so we can review it.
It should be reviewed by a public works.
And then send to the chair. And then a resolution accepted. So if you could talk to Mr. Root about that, I think we should do it more formal. Especially since when I was at one of the meetings, there was a discussion how it gets installed. And someone said that there should be a concrete port. Well, whatever your concrete being poured, you know, well, if it's in the playground area, if a kid falls off it, does he fall on concrete?
Or is it on?
Yeah. So, or is it just a footing and it's buried deep, like, you know, and things like that. So, but I think it's going in the playground area, and that's why you have to know where in the playground area it's definitely going. The pavilion turned out great if everybody saw the pavilion.
Yeah.
You know.
Is it finished yet?
The pavilion's not a dedicated one.
Beautiful.
Didn't you see, we had a great write-up?
You need to take your lunch there.
Did the insurance company come down and look at it yet?
You don't know, you can let them know. You know, it was built with a construction permit, there was engineering done. Belmar did the concrete work for us, and then some wonderful sign company installed it.
I'll tell you, that sign's just amazing.
All right, Mr. Farrell?
Okay, thanks, Mayor. I was going to talk about the building, doors being delayed, but now we know it's going to be, they're going to start in 2 weeks, 6 weeks it'll be done. So that's good. Waiting for the funds for Washington Avenue and Oakland Avenue, hopefully we'll get to it this year.
Yes, right. We have a commitment with the DOT for $200,000.
Correct.
We may get up to another $200,000, if possible.
Okay. Well, let's just stop there, just to jump into your report, do you know when we'll go up for a bid for the?
I'm hoping to do it within a month.
Oh, okay. Is that in your report?
Well.
I talked to the mayor about sidewalks on Davis Road. Just something to talk about, kids are walking in the street, we've been talking about it since the 3 years I've been on. Two of the blocks would be very easy, that would be a no-brainer. But when you get to the.
That last block, right, the shoulder is tough.
But I looked at it.
Needs a retaining wall possibly.
Yeah, but a small, you don't need like a gigantic wall.
Well, just to piggyback, I did meet with Belmar, if you remember, I said that Belmar was willing to do some work for us. So we haven't got numbers from them, but if they give us work on flat ground, granted, they won't be able to do stuff that needs a retaining wall and stuff like that, but maybe what you're talking about, the two, the easy blocks. We might be able to get a few of those easy blocks done this year.
Yeah, I just think two reasons, kids' safety and...
Well, you can see the paths where they're walking.
Right, and it would be a nice running from, you could start a trail and run all the way around past the Acme, you know.
You're doing circles and trees.
Also, timetable on the curbs at the Lux Bakery.
Well, that's a funding issue. You guys haven't done any drawings on that yet, have you? Why don't you give us a number on what the design is for those? Because it wasn't in any design. You ever seen, you saw the blueprints that were submitted. The county drew just the curb on the one side. We need to show sidewalk and curb on the outside. And the agreement we tentatively have with the Deluxe Bakery is that we'll put the curb in, they'll put the sidewalk in, and they'll put the other curb in. But that's a funding issue too, but we still need to know what it will cost to get the... Get your drawings together, it's going to cost whatever, and we'll get the money together. We have to get it done this year, that's our agreement with the Lux.
The last but not least, Cooper Medical, looking great. The grade seems really high to me, but...
It looks high, but it's deceiving.
Yeah, they know what they're doing, so I'm sure it'll look good when it's all done.
Yeah? Oh, you don't do the inspections out there? You don't do that?
No, it's our design.
Oh, sure, it's not.
So I know it's right.
I know that's our officer. That's why we were confused.
The only thing I want to add to that, that you brought up sidewalks, was I went to a meeting and I just happened to be sitting next to the guys from PSE&G. Of course, I had to say something to them. There are no sidewalks in front of the PSE&G property on Evesham Road. And I just happened to be sitting with the two guys in charge of that facility. And so I met with one of them out there. And they are coming in front of the planning board because they're doing some upgrades to that electrical substation they have there. They're going to be pouring some concrete and doing some stuff.
No, down the hill.
Past the Acme, towards Magnolia, on the left hand side. And so I met them down there and they said, look, we're going to be, they already had it staked out, they must be doing drawings to show that they're going to be putting some additional equipment down there. And they basically, after I met with them and said there's no sidewalks, they sent back an email saying that part of their planning board application will be to finish the sidewalk and pave. Because you know how they have stone? Every time the big trucks pull out on Evesham Road, they drag the stones out. So they're going to asphalt to the gate, and then they're going to put sidewalks. And while we were standing out there, it couldn't have been a better time. The kids were walking out of school from Triton, because it was a nice day. And they were coming, walking in the middle of Evesham Road towards Magnolia.
No sidewalk.
The irony was neither of the kids were from Runnymede. Both were from Gloucester Township because they walked down on our side and they crossed over to go to that part of right between where Magnolia and Gloucester Township merges. So we're talking about sidewalks, you know. And that whole project, if everybody remembers.
Bridge across there too.
They're gonna do something, I'm not sure, they want it, they're gonna do something. They, you're right, they're gonna need to build a bridge, they're gonna have to do something.
If they're connecting the two sidewalks.
Right.
Yeah, but they're gonna put in their application, which is great. So now there'll be sidewalks basically from Magnolia all the way to the Black Horse Pike, from White Horse Pike to the Black Horse Pike. Then we just have to yell at Dave over in Gloucester Township. He's got no sidewalks in his city.
Who's paying for it?
His hands.
Yeah, 50, I saw it.
Wow.
Well, it's part of their application.
How big is this strip is? Roughly?
90 feet, 100 feet? Maybe more?
More probably.
Maybe more than 100 feet. Is that?
If you want to yell at anybody from Gloucester Township, I'm their taxpayer, so we gotta.
6 o'clock.
7 o'clock? See? I didn't talk to him today.
You didn't talk to him, that's your job.
Dress rehearsal.
She's the, she's the whip, she's our majority whip over here. It's caucus tonight.
6 o'clock.
Seven.
Well, maybe you're right.
How was that last week?
You can watch it on the video.
Well, Gloucester Township, well, just to go back, in 2008, Camden County started off this whole project.
Do you want to give an email or text?
To put sidewalks, that's what started this. So we started putting sidewalks on Eve Shaver. Then the county paid Schubert to put more sidewalks on Schubert. So this is the last little stretch to finish the connection to Magnolia. And then, 1 year later, and then that's what Mr. Farrell was talking about on Davis, you're racing around the whole school. But that's a little, it's a hard area.
Yeah.
And last but not least, the pipe on Orchard Avenue, I was down there today, there's only one section from being totally done. It is done, so.
Oh, you guys got it done today, huh?
I left around,
I thought they weren't coming back for a while.
Two.
One day, they took one day off, that's awesome.
Yeah, that's good, so.
Yeah, we fixed the pipe that's been broken for 50 years.
And we were down there.
Orchard Avenue, past Bangor, and the gully, it's a brand new pipe, it's phenomenal.
How's the pothole situation coming along? On Fridays, are we still doing that, or what's going on?
Yes, on a couple of ones that you passed on me, there's some skins that came off. It's not actually a pothole, it's where they've done an overlay or something like that, some pieces. We're actually going after the potholes that are 6 inches, 4 inches.
The ones that you have to kind of dig out and rock patch?
We've been working on that, yeah.
So it's not a true pothole, it's a.
Yeah, it's cosmetic, so we're trying to get the true potholes done.
Right, okay.
And then go back after the cosmetic one, as soon as we get caught up. Because we have a list right now for this Friday, I think there's about 42 on it.
And Hill and Union is on there, right? Because that was like number one 2 years ago. Yeah, okay, good.
We'll let Mr. Basher, anyone want to go last, then we'll come back to Mr. Did we talk about Schubert?
Yeah.
That's right.
So Bob, did you talk about Schubert?
No, I was going to mention that you had called me on that.
Yeah, I stopped here yesterday and talked to them.
Talked to who?
The county.
Oh, okay.
The county had this redone Schubert by Eshan. And they took it up, they went down like 5-6 inches.
Oh, got repaired already?
Yeah, and it's all repaired now. And it's very nice.
Okay, that's great.
There are some lines in the pavement. I asked them what they were, and they said those are for the lights. But,
oh yeah, they're sensors.
Yeah.
To turn the lights, to change the lights.
Yeah. Right. It looks very nice, I thanked them, and they had a change at the top in the county and the streets. So this guy said he wanted to do it like 6 months ago, but then things got pushed back.
Well, they did it. They're a bad job at the first.
Yeah.
They don't like to do base work.
Yeah, they did a nice job. It was much better.
Mr. Basher, you want to go? We'll let Mr. Stowe.
Okay. Just a couple of things. Bob touched on some, Steve had touched on some things that aren't in my report that I forgot to mention. Is we have open space applications due in the middle to end of March. The past few years, my group did those for the RYAA. We helped if needed, and we haven't been needed much other than helping with lot numbers recently.
We'll get together with you.
Yeah, that would be Mr. Lobenstein down. So we need to get that $25,000.
Yeah.
We definitely want to get it in. The only thing I think that Craig and I talked briefly about it, make sure maybe you should on this first one help out a little bit more because we we want to make sure we're going to get approved. We missed last year's. And it has to be one, an application that benefits the whole community.
Yeah.
That's the big, right, the big issue with things like that.
Right.
You know?
So we might try and walk. Do you have any idea what you want to use it for? Or is it looking at the girl softball? Are you looking at the RYAA?
We should meet personally around that.
I'm thinking more of down at Green Acres, exercise stations.
Okay.
So we might have to make a resolution next Tuesday.
So you only have till Tuesday?
Yeah, a resolution on it, to figure out what you want to do. We have to, I think, the 22nd, get the application in.
Okay.
We should have a resolution on next Tuesday.
To authorize the application.
What do you mean exercise station?
We did.
Yeah.
What are they? People walk around, and they'll go to one station, do pull-ups. You'll go to the next station, you'll do leg raises. To the next station, you will do stretching. The next station, there's all sorts of different stations that you go, like 10 stations around the course of the mile. And then as you stop,
so what do you
want to use different parts of you work on different parts of your body.
So what do you need in order to do that? Bars?
Their equipment.
Equipment.
It's all pressure treated lumber, it's all outdoors, so some ropes to climb.
Some of it's metal, a lot of those ball bars.
That's a lot of the Sewell and Washington Township parks have them.
Yeah.
Is this
it's
like
nice, people like them, they really do like them.
So you're thinking that they're along the 9/10 path?
Yes.
You're thinking not all in one area.
Right.
You're thinking as you go around the that's interesting.
Yeah.
I mean, logistically, though, maybe it would probably work a little bit because they would have to be maintained a little bit.
John, you would say you would talk to Wawa about the backboards. Did you get any back there?
Wawa's kind of pulled out right now because of Oil Farms and they're
okay. Well, that would.
I don't want to be,
Harry can talk about backboards.
It's kind of on hold, but I'm going to ask him again before Oil Farms does open.
Okay.
Is that open space? Is that qualified?
Well, recreation. $25,000 is recreation, open space. It's the same application.
Tennis courts. And was there a problem with the tennis courts?
Well, all I know is about the tennis courts. If those
well, tennis courts, we have to repair that.
That's right.
That wouldn't necessarily be part of this grant. I mean, you'd like to get the grant to do something specifically.
I don't think we should. I think there should be some talk. We shouldn't narrow down to one thing, a couple of ideas. Your committee maybe could talk.
Well, it has to be an application, and we only have until 22nd.
Yeah, we only have to.
All right, forget that.
Never
mind.
All you need by next week is
a resolution, but then you have a month.
If you want to work on anything at the Green Acres part, you just have a resolution that we're going to submit an application for the Green Acres.
But something that touches the people, and that's your point, Green Acres touches a lot of people.
I don't see myself climbing a roof up there.
Well, it's not the step on the Green Acres, it's not a rope. There's different, you work on different sections of your body as you
climb.
We'll look at it. What else did you
have? I had some humor here.
A lot of the CDBG applications are going to be due. Year 39 by March 31st, and then I need a resolution for that. We talked about applying for funds for the parking lot.
Yes.
So,
well, last year and this year, we used two.
Yeah, we're on the 38 and 39. So we need a resolution for that.
All right, Joyce, you hear that? We're going to go
rest. I didn't get the packet.
You didn't get the packet?
Yeah. Did they come out yet?
I haven't seen them, but I've heard applications are due by March 31st.
Well, they usually are due by the end of March, but I haven't seen yet.
Okay. Do you know Bob Harris? You have his email? We just shoot him an email.
Yeah, but we should get that.
Because I really want to go after that supplemental funding with him, too, but he still hasn't seen an application for that.
Yeah, but I don't know how much it is. Do you even know what it is this year, the amount?
And that's about $35,000, but we're just using multi-year to help offset our costs on the parking lot.
But I would just rather get the resolution on next week's agenda.
Well, that's the project description form. So what am I saying?
What I have to do is say that you authorize Fox Associates to submit the project description form.
Okay, same for generic resolution.
For Borough Hall parking lot.
Borough Hall parking lot.
And then we can work out the details. I only have to have a special meeting in March.
No.
Just to be able to pass
right. Well, we have the caucus too. Okay. In March.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but if it's due.
March 30th before March 31st.
But if you shoot him an email, CC me, because I like to see. Because he keeps telling me about the supplemental application, and he doesn't send out the application. I know, it's been.
The other thing is we did submit the application for fiscal year 2017 state aid for Elm Avenue and Broadway.
Oh,
sent them the resolution, so hopefully we'll hear about that soon, especially before the meeting started, the mayor said the state started passing budgets, so hopefully that will help us with that. CDBG U 38, we talked about transferring funds to the parking lot. I want to help the mayor with a letter to CDBG of how we get the transfer started, so I will be coordinating that with him.
The only thing we want to talk about that is, you know, one of the things we always talk about is we have shovel-ready projects. These kind of things where we've done our design and we know what it would take to fix that intersection. You know, if we ever want a project in the future, can we just take it off the shelf and get the funding and do it? Do we have any of those sitting on the shelf right now, other than this is probably the only one? Things that we actually started a drawing and it's sitting there.
We do, but it won't qualify for CDBG. We had that Bowers Avenue drainage.
Bowers Avenue.
We had the bike path.
Can you put that in your engineering, that is, that, remember that?
The report here, when you put it on hold, and said we didn't have funding for it.
But I mean, if you put it on that.
Oh,
the engineering repair.
Yeah, and that.
Because then if we get money, because Bowers is, we talked about, right, finishing the, well, fixing the drain and then fixing that road a little bit. Bowers by the RYA fields over there. That always floods.
Yeah.
And then.
Is that a big project?
It was, and that's why we kind of tabled it. But my point, though, is like the CDBG, when they have supplemental funding, they only want to award it to people who are literally sitting with.
Waiting to go.
We're ready to start. See you back.
That makes sense.
But if you have to do drawings, they don't want to give you the money. Am I saying this correctly? That they want you to be sitting there waiting for them to do it.
But the only problem is that project would not qualify.
Do you understand the story?
Well, we will add that to.
But I'm just saying, if we have these things sitting on the shelf, and you know, we want to say, oh, you know what, let's get Bowers resolved.
We will add that to the capital problem.
But Oakland stopped flooding since we fixed that pipe, didn't it?
For the time being, yes. But the Bowers would
no credit.
What?
For the time being.
Hey,
I'll go to the school capital and have you go there. Building demolition, I finally got to close out the bathrooms from Delphi. I just have to review them and I'll pass it through the solicitor. It's just there some signed and sealed documents. I just want to make sure everything's in line before we release the retained on that project.
Are we going to do that in March or are you still?
Depends how fast the solicitor works.
Lawyers work a lot faster than engineers. That's my experience.
That still holds them.
The demo.
And we decided, we talked about this when Len was here, of not having a 2-year maintenance bond because the parking lot got tore up. So all we need to do is get certification of prevailing wages were paid and the release of lien form that we need to get signed.
From one of their subcontractors?
Just from them.
Oh, okay.
Anybody will not sue the borough if he didn't pay his subs or his supplier. It's just a release of lien. So I just have to get that passed through and we can make a recommendation to release the change on that.
Gotcha.
The parking lot, we have not released anything. Still coordinating, we're waiting for the spring to see how the asphalt held up. There will be some punch list work out there. There's some weightiness in two of the concrete sections. So there's going to be punch list work on that. We're just waiting for better weather to see how the entire asphalt held up.
Mark, quick question.
Yes.
Where is the other bricks with all the names?
There are no, all the names got put back in.
Oh, there's nothing else? Well, that was it.
They were just spread out.
Really?
Before we have it.
So much bigger.
All the names are in where the bike racks are. They were all used. The rest of the bricks were just thrown out at the direction of the borough. Steve already talked about this project here with the change order, so we'll get that moving forward. Sanitary sewer slip lining. We had a pre-con last Wednesday. I have to get some documents approved by the solicitor, and I'll work with Dan on that because I sent stuff to him. Then. What?
You're giving me so much stuff to do.
I just sent you the email with it, so
is there,
it,
yeah, no, not so far.
I didn't know when Len was getting back, so.
He's getting back later this week.
Okay.
See you later again.
Well, we're trying to get that moving by March 6th. I want to do the notice receipt for that.
But we've already signed the contracts on this, right?
You signed the contracts, but I haven't got.
A blessing.
Concurrence on the bonds and
oh.
the insurance certificate.
just want to make sure everything's on the up and up before we cut the contractor loose. So I'm anticipating we'll have that done by March 6th, and the notice proceed will be for next Monday. The Orchard Avenue, Bob talked about that, the new pipes in, all the bypass pumping.
100% done.
Now, the pipe is done. We still have to do some grouting where it goes across the pedestals. We're putting straps on top of the pedestals.
Are we putting any of it, any kind of a gate to keep the kids from?
That's not part of this contract.
It's not.
Public Works.
We can do it after the fact.
If we want to do a three quote, we can do that, but nothing's in this contract.
To keep it, all right. So we can do that after the fact.
But the
bypass. To keep the children from walking across them.
Yeah, I can't believe they walk across those pipes.
And they, you know, that's why there's, we're not kids anymore.
You want an exercise equipment, there's free exercise.
Yeah, balance across that, huh?
They used to ride bikes across it.
What?
So there is still some work to do out there, but the bypass is done. I don't know if anybody heard, but last Friday there was an issue out there when they started the bypass pumping. There was a sewage leak. Harry was on top of it. Our inspector was on top of it. DEP was notified. We got the site cleaned up quickly, and DEP was happy with how we.
It was minimal.
It was minimal.
DEP was out.
We followed the necessary procedures. Even called wives that were supposed to get called, but that's been resolved.
So Orchard Avenue sewer, they won't want to get, they'll get paid next month, is that what you think?
Yes.
They'll be done, they haven't submitted any invoices. They work fast, that's great, we should pay them fast. Do things like that.
My report, unless anybody else, anything else?
Yeah. Mr. Longstein, I do apologize, but, you know, did you have anything to report? I mean, you were engaged, but.
Fields were done for softball and baseball. They've been done. Now watch, we'll get snow.
There's tryouts tomorrow. Did you hear that?
Yes, I heard that. I've been on the phone quite a bit back and forth.
Yeah.
I'm trying to have the schools talk to the organizations, and Harry's, I'm sure, talked to some of them, and Joyce has too. And Harry Williams this weekend, you were there. It was very busy. I think they did a pretty good job of cleaning up. I saw them. How was it Monday morning, Harry? Good. And I talked to both Mr. Henry and Mr. Garcia, and they had the brooms out, and they were sweeping up. Not them necessarily, but their minions. And they were sweeping up. Harry, if we could, I guess those two big mops are getting pretty worn. Big long mops that were handled, the ones that you push, the brooms, they look pretty dirty. I don't know if we have any more or not.
They were just washed.
Are they? Okay.
I'll have the guys take a look at it. They're dry off, yeah.
Yeah, dry, okay. And the rest is progress.
Okay. So what's up?
Progress.
No. You came here tonight to say progress? Mr. Root said you had something to report.
Well, we already went over the street opening.
So street opening, the trash truck?
Trash truck. Green Acres. Three quarters of the old softball fence is taken down as of today. Okay, so that's where we're hoping to finish up.
It's taken down and out of there. It's just laying down there.
As of today, they were doing a large section. They got it down and it piled up. Tomorrow they're removing it out, and they got the small section to the far side to remove. And then next week we're going to take down the back side of the softball base itself.
Didn't you need the soccer nets moved from RY down to Green Acres? Mm-hmm. Is that something that I could do?
That's being scheduled to be moved from the fields from RY down to Green Acres.
Is there a deadline to move them down? Do they need to be done?
They're going to be down before the weekend.
Oh, before the weekend. Okay.
Yeah.
I do live next to Richie Ford, so.
I feel sorry for that. Mowers are being started. With the weather the way it's going right now, so we'll probably be cutting in the next week or two.
Drayton was cutting today.
Really?
Yeah. Drayton's cutting. So with soccer starting, baseball starting, we're trying to get up on it. So the shop is very packed with, you know, still being prepared for snow and all that, plus, you know, trying to get all the spring stuff going.
Are we taking care of the vacant homes this year, or are we still? still some in there?
Well, we have a contractor.
It's less homes.
It should be less homes, I just told you about all the, you know.
Yeah, definitely 40.
But we still have agreement with, you know, that vendor who comes in and does additional cutting. It doesn't preclude the Public Works Department from doing it. I mean, whomever gets the order can go out and cut the grass. I guess we won't know about it until I probably wouldn't say May or June.
Yeah.
When, you know, they have to get cited and the whole process.
But with our schedule with the fields and everything else, we'll probably use the vendor to maintain them again. Because it's still, we still get paid for it reimbursed because the vendor gets paid and then we get an administrative fee on it. So.
Why not? Keep the guys free.
With that, it keeps us to be handling all the other projects, which we do have a busy slate. The street sweeper's been out. I was told there are several pictures on the social media sites about the sweeper being out. The town is.
I have a couple of streets they should just go up and down until someone comes out with a camera.
Correct.
They could do that.
Three quarters of the town has been done. Okay, we're hoping to have it finished up Friday, and then we're actually going to go back onto our schedule that we have, where we have the town going up four sections, and the sweeper will be in one section per week.
How's the feedback? How's the feedback? People moving their cars off the streets?
Well, it's just, they're seeing it.
Yeah, we're not telling people that we're coming, we're just showing it up.
We're just showing, we're just trying to get the stuff up.
We need to get some lettering on that street.
Stasis, probably all the trucks that are still pending. No one needs one.
Okay.
It's
not me.
Uh-oh.
No, it's a friend of mine.
Anyway, that's just pros up. Going into today, we had next Tuesday, we had demo for slip lining through permaline that was approved a while back.
Was that the one on Central or where was that?
We were looking at doing on Black Horse Pike in front of the music shop at 4th and 5th, but through the video we found out that construction of the handicap sidewalk has crushed the first 10 feet and it's actually has to be dug up and redone, but it cannot be slip lined. Right now it is flowing.
So this is that property we've been having some problems?
No, it's on the corner. It's not.
Not where the music shop is?
No. It was on the J-trap that was removed.
So he fixed that?
That's fixed and repaired. So with that, we were looking at another section on Center Avenue that was on the original slip lining sheet for, you know, areas that needed to be done. So it's Center to 3rd Avenue. It's about 238 feet. We videoed that today. The vendor has that, verify everything, the footage and all that, make sure, you know, there's a couple extra lateral cutouts they have to do. With that, on Center Avenue, we went down since we had, when the pipe video company comes in, we get charged minimum of 4 hours. I like to work for the 4 hours. I get our dollar.
So there you saw the first pipe and then you went to the other?
So there was a sinkhole down on Center Avenue. It was previously slip lined. Videoed it and found out looking up through a lateral 6 inches in off the main, the lateral is a 2-inch hole and it's 9 feet down. So to dig it up and repair just that lateral is astronomical. So we're actually looking at, we're getting the price right now.
And you're saying this was previously slip lined?
Yeah, the main. But
you're
it's
outside
the lateral. I wasn't here for that. Yeah. This was a 15 or 20 year project ago.
Wow. That was done. It was probably done through the run meet soon or at the time.
But everything's flowing. You just have to.
It's flowing, no.
But there's a hole.
There's a sinkhole in the street, so it's going to create a bigger hole, and that's where you see, you know.
And the pipe was 9 feet down.
Yes. So with that, we're looking at our options of having a company do from the clean out to the main, slip lining to the lateral. That's the most economical way. So we're getting the price of going out right now. Over on Williams Avenue, from Mr. Kennard's house, we looked there. There's a storm drain that runs along the curb line, not the sanitary sewer.
Oh, I thought it was just, that's it.
Not knowing the system fully. So that is approximately 6.5 feet down.
I thought it was only 3 feet down.
That's on the sanitary sewer.
The storm.
This is a storm. The 16-inch pipe, or actually 18-inch storm pipe, the invert at the manhole, where the pipe puts into the manhole, it has cracked right around the outside edge, and its infiltration can actually cause a sinkhole up above coming in. So with that one, that can actually be repaired, we'll do it in-house, where we can go down and order a patch and wrap a hole.
Now, can you dig down 6 feet?
We'll go inside the manhole.
Oh, you can go from the inside?
We'll do it from the inside, we'll do the fire space stuff, go in, and we can actually do a patch repair from the inside with a storm, so.
Is that in-house?
Yeah.
We'll do that in-house.
Yeah.
That would save us a lot for that one, so. The integrity of the pipe is fine, we looked at both directions, it's just the, where the connection was, the water fell through, and it's been a patch they've done before, they've cut open and packed it.
But you can see through the patch.
Never got to the root, so the easiest way to get to it is look at the camera, and that's what we did. So since we had the camera in for going, we just kept going at it, so. Just to bring everybody up on to speed with that, so that would be something that we'll be working on in the next week or two also.
So Tuesday, Central of Third Avenue?
Yes.
What time?
Probably start at 7 o'clock.
Okay, stop down and check it out?
Oh, we want everybody to come out and check it out, and want to process it, so.
How long will that take?
Probably until lunchtime.
This is this company that uses steam?
Yes.
So it's faster, so?
Yeah. It's on my schedule.
So we're gonna look at it, just see the.
You know what's great, if we do the water and the steam, we get to see both.
You get to see both, and then we just have that information for future. We're not gonna stop the existing project that Tuesday night, but through the authorization.
And this was already on the.
Mr. Bach, we talked about it, and came up with his concerns, and we'll say the announcement's getting done.
Center of Fort.
So there's a crushed pipe on the bottom of the pipe?
Yeah. From the sidewalk, guys.
Harry, is it third and center? That's on the other side of the pipe?
Yes.
There's center.
Center goes down the lake.
Oh, okay.
Mary used to live there.
I did, 412 Center.
So, that's where, that's, and like I said, we've been busy public works, player benches have thrown in for Harry Williams going, they'll be put together.
Construction benches, okay, so he said that to me and I wasn't.
Yeah, in the next couple of days, we're looking for the bad weather for the guys to do it. Because right now, we're trying to do everything outside with the fair weather.
All right, we do have to, just remind you, we have to amend our ordinance for the Triton Junior Wrestling wants to come in and use the Harry Williams building during the off-season in the summer. We allow the RY, we should in our application, we have to review our ordinance, we should exempt these organizations that are affiliated with the municipality or, you know, even with the school. And that's the problem. Joyce pointed it out when the coach called up and said he wanted 10 weeks in the summertime, 2 days a week, Triton would bring the mats over, and then they would roll the mats up in case we decide to do anything else. But for those twice a week or three times a week for 10 weeks, he wants to be able to use it, we'd have to, I think we should allow them to be exempt, just how I feel RY, RG, you know, anything that's affiliated with us should be exempt from using it.
They would still have to put up the 300,000.
They still all follow the rules,
yeah.
But the fee that an Oregon outside organization, is typically the daily rate is $100, or $25 if you look at St. Teresa's, but even St. Teresa's, we gave a discounted rate because they use it for 100 days, and we allow them to, it's a lot cheaper to pay us $2,500 than to build a gym. They don't pay any utility bills. So I just want us, and more than likely, I might ask us to look at this for Tuesday, because we should get it at least read, because we have to read it twice.
Yeah. The only thing I would suggest is that the wrestling, just because of the mats, there's a lot of infections and stuff like that, just make sure that they understand that they're obligated to wipe down.
Yeah, they're not our mats. They're the high school's mats. Yeah, I think there's two things. Yeah, the ordinance, in my opinion, I'm more concerned about our fees.
Right.
But you're right on the process side.
Exactly.
We should say about process, like I said, Mr. Lobstein said we made the RY clean up this weekend, and they did a much better job because they were pushed a little bit more to clean it. But that's us enforcing our
exactly.
our rules. And I agree. Did you wrestle?
I did not. I did say to them, I said, you guys don't pay anything to use this building.
Yeah.
If we have to start bringing the public works and clean the building up, we're going to charge you.
I don't know it.
Yeah. And it's so easy when there's so many people there. When there's 10 guys there, it's so easy to clean up.
Sure. It was packed.
And it was packed.
It was packed. It was great.
Yeah.
Did they leave those stickers on the wall? Are they still on there? Did they?
Stickers are off the wall. There's two posters off for spring events, but that's all.
Okay. Was there anything else? Did you have anything from legal?
Yeah, just, I mean, first of all, we discussed the Verizon that we're working on. Obviously, the shared service agreement with the county and that ordinance. Took a look at the trash truck purchase. Beyond that, I've always wanted to say this, progress.
Progress.
But I've enjoyed being your acting solicitor the last few weeks. Let me come back soon, so thanks for having me.
What's up with Verizon?
Pleasure.
Verizon is, they...
Putting files in all over town?
Yeah. They have these nodes that are these 20-inch long, I guess, gadgets that they stick up top of existing utility poles. They need to get our permission in order to do that because they're located within the borough's right-of-way. We're required to give them permission, but we can impose reasonable restrictions like insurance requirements as well as...
I can't think of a file.
Is this so Verizon can put files in all over the town of Runnymede?
He wants five.
Wi-Fi, all the free Wi-Fi.
Especially on Mitchell Avenue?
Now that would be something to...
Negotiate, huh?
That, you know, if it's Wi-Fi, I would say, then you definitely charge it.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so it's a lot of the we just did the bank on that. It's where I'm assisting. We can't withhold it, but they still need our permission. And we can't work so far.
Oh, move on. See, I'm a little longer than Patty, huh, guys? 7:15? Okay, this portion of the meeting is open to the public. Anyone wishing to speak, please come to the microphone. Come on up. Tell us how good that Oakland Avenue. Tell us that it hasn't flooded. Come on.
All right. That's Palisano, 831 North Oakland Avenue. And no, we have not flooded. However, we have been in drought state off of Pondo for the past 2.5 years. So, yes, but it has.
But you knew there was a tree branch in that pipe. Is that unbelievable all those years?
Yes, considering that.
I know, you've been complaining, and we put a camera in there. These cameras are amazing.
They are. And the other thing is the sweeper is good, but when we can, we need to announce. Luckily, I heard him on the other side of the street.
Was he ready?
I ran out and moved my car.
That's why I asked that question.
Not as before, but it would be better, but how do we announce? Do we know when we're going out? Are we getting it?
We will. We have the schedule that was posted last year. We'll put that back up on the website.
On your quarterly?
Yeah.
Or your semi-annual?
Well, the newsletter, it might not be a bad. If you're willing to commit to it, Harry, we can put it in writing. And
if I get something within the next 2 weeks, week or two, I can put it. But, you know, the sign's coming, electronic sign. That'll
help too.
That'll be very helpful, right?
That's what.
You're going to appreciate cars being moved, I'm sure.
Yeah.
A lot more, you get a lot cleaner curbs if you have no vehicles. Because I know you're probably going around every other car.
Yes, yeah.
Well, everybody's supposed to be at work. What were you doing home?
Waiting to pick the kids up at school and run them around on their errands.
When that happens, and you do go around vehicles, is there still cleaning in the middle of the road as it does that? Okay, yeah. So it's something, yeah.
But it's not the age where it's there,
yes.
Okay.
Yes.
But you're right, we do need to do a better job of cleaning. But
the next time, the car's moved back where it's clean and then the guy gets in the third. Every couple of weeks, you'll, because it's also not going to be just four times a year you'll see the sweeper. You're going to see it out constantly.
That's great. Okay.
Thank you.
Thanks, Val.
Anyone else? Dan? All right, seeing no one else, is there a motion to close the public portion? Motion by Ms. Lobenstein, second by Mr. Neary. All in favor?
Aye.
Public portion is closed. Is there a motion to adjourn?
I'll make a motion.
Motion by Mr. Lobenstein, second by Mr. Neary. All in favor?
Aye.
We are adjourned.